So Stuart took you through some enhancements to the server side of building this. I'd like to talk to you a bit about the client side. Custom components, that's really what Stuart was trying to do here, or what he did. You can write those in JavaScript, but I'd like to talk to you a bit about ECMAScript. So quick show of hands, just I'm going to try and speak talk here, but I want to know first, how many of you know about JavaScript? Okay, it's pretty much everybody. How many knows about ECMAScript? Okay, fewer than that. How many of you ever built a custom component for Dataflex? Okay, that's a few here. That's good to know. It is there's a nice section in the Dataflex online help about building custom controls. You can pretty much walk through that and figure out how to do it. It involves writing a Dataflex class and a matching JavaScript class, and those two will talk together and make everything work transparently. The client side of it looks like this. So that's the syntax you would use. This is JavaScript code. Now, JavaScript doesn't have classes, it has prototypical inheritance, so it looks a bit strange compared to the Dataflex class. This is not prototypical inheritance. I think DataAxis wrote something that mimics a class system, or they borrowed one. But you don't really want to write this. You don't really want to have handwritten JavaScript code or any code running in your production environment. You would really like to have a compiler, transpiler, something to check that code, possibly help you write it. That's where ECMAScript comes in. So really simple component, the client side of it, the JavaScript part of it. This is really basic. This is a hello world. If you were to do it the way that the help system in Dataflex shows you how to do it. So there's a class set up here. It has an open HTML method, a close HTML method, and an after render method, a single property that you can change to show something. So this is what the JavaScript would look like. If we were to write that in ECMAScript, it would look like what it looks like on the right here. So ECMAScript has classes. JavaScript doesn't, but ECMAScript does. You have a class syntax you can extend, and those classes have constructors and real methods. The interesting thing is that although the ECMAScript classes are different from the JavaScript prototypical inheritance, it's also the same, and because the DataAxis base system works off the prototypical inheritance, you can actually, with an ECMAScript class, extend the JavaScript classes, the parts of the DF engine. So you can do this, make a component that extends the web-based control from Dataflex, and that works. It's less code to write, there's less repetition. Over here, you'd have to repeat the name, my component, over and over again. You don't do that in ECMAScript. And so that makes it easier to write, easier to read. And with the ECMAScript, you can't run that in a browser, or most browsers won't run it, depending on which features of ECMAScript you use, but you can transpile it to JavaScript. So you use a build tool, much like the Dataflex compiler. For that, you need something called Node.js. Node.js is a free download. It's on the internet. This is where you get it. Node gives you access to NPM, which is the world's largest software registry. It's been for some time now. They have, right about now, something along 900,000 open source packages on NPM. So that's a lot of software out there that you get free access to, easy access to, by installing Node.js. This is all JavaScript, or ECMAScript, or TypeScript, or whatever other types they support. You can find everything on there. One of the things you can find on there is AmCharts for version 3. NPM was not the preferred method of obtaining it, but if you look at their website now, number one method of downloading AmCharts is to install it through NPM. If you do that, what you get is the TypeScript-enabled ECMAScript version of AmCharts. So it's not really JavaScript that you're downloading this way. You need to do something with it. And so I've done that. Stura asked me to make a custom component version of his AmCharts thing. And so this is what a simple AmCharts component would look like. On the left, there's the ECMAScript class AmCharts component, which extends the web-based control. So it's a Dataflex custom control. It has a constructor, it has the open-close methods, the after render, and a single method to pass the data object that Stura was explaining to you how to build the JSON object that contains the entire configuration. On the right side, that's the Dataflex class that goes with that. Doesn't really contain much. It mentions the name of the JavaScript class and the ECMAScript class, and it has a single method to pass the JSON data. And I'm not going to talk to you about how you generate the JSON data. You just follow Stura's instructions. I'm sure that'll get you there. So, quick example. We have put the AmCharts component that I made on GitHub. So you can get it from there. And I will try to show you. So this is GitHub. You can see that on the other screen too, I hope.
Yeah.
So this is what's up there. If you look at what's in it, it's basically the Dataflex workspace. So it has all the Dataflex workspace folders. And it has a single additional folder called SRC, which contains the ECMAScript class. That's in here, that's what I showed you before. And I know we're running over time. Get you out to a coffee break in just a minute. Okay, so this is a download of the GitHub repository. So this has all the same files. Apart from the index that contains the source code, there's also a few configuration files in here. What you need to do with npm is have a package JSON that contains the dependencies that you need to build this stuff. And then there's a few configuration files for the tools used. I am just going to try. The instructions are on GitHub, but what you do with this, let's see if we can make this bigger, is you download it, install Node.js, run npm install, that'll pull down all the dependencies into your local workspace. So that's going to take a moment here. This is downloading literally thousands of packages. And almost there. Don't worry about the warnings. Then there's a single command to build the JavaScript version of this. So this takes the ECMAScript class, the small ECMAScript class that I wrote, pulls in all the dependencies, and builds some JavaScript for us. And while it does that, I'll scroll up over here. This is the app.html folder. As you see, there's the usual files in there. Once the build is done running, a few warnings here also, because AmCharts is fairly large. And so the Webpack builder that I use, it has some size warnings telling you this is probably going to be a slow download for the users. But it's not that bad. It ends up around 800 kilobytes.
And what we get for this is also the ability to run on all kinds of browsers.
Yes.
Okay,
yes. What this does is it takes a single class. It takes some configuration files. One of those configuration files is a specification of which browsers we want this to run on. If you want to support old browsers, you can. That'll generate a bit more JavaScript code. Newer browsers, that'll generate less. It generates a single folder in our app.html. It has an index.js, that's the only one we'll need to load in our index.html. There are a few others here, these are called webpack chunks. So they will be loaded on demand only if we need them. And final thing, I'll just pull up the studio over here. And hopefully, this is the same workspace. I will be able to run it. So This is just a simple workspace that has a couple of views. Bingo. So this pulling, the index.js that I just built and uses the custom component. You can find all the source code on GitHub for the Dataflex parts as well. But this is mCharts 4 running here. It has the features that Stora showed. They moved the mCharts text that was in version 3. That's now a small icon down here. So that's the one you can remove by paying for a license. It's not very intrusive. And there are some buttons in here just to show you that you can change the chart. This calls the API in the custom component. There's a Pi demo in here, I think. Yeah. There's a size issue that I haven't quite figured out yet. This also shows event handling, which is also on GitHub. So if you click something here, that'll fire a Dataflex event that will fill out a form field down here. So, there's my mouse, other side. That was my example.
I have a question.
Questions?
Jeff, is it possible to use this, to get a hold on this without going through the install and the build?
Yes, of course, you can contact me. I can send you a pre-built workspace if you just need to use it. But also, this is a nice example to use if you're looking into building custom components yourself. So that could be used for you.
Good.
Okay?
Yeah.
Let's get some coffee.